All right, we have a game to talk about today.
Woo!
Do we have a game to talk about today? Hi, welcome back to the channel. Now, I know you're used to seeing like the cinematic reviews, but two things about that before we start. One, I did do a cinematic showcase on it, which you can see linked here down below. Now I paired that up with a preview of the game, so if you want to see more of a deep dive into how Bloodstone plays, definitely check out that video. Now secondly, I want your opinion on this one. I do want to put out more game reviews, but the problem is, the intro cinematics take me a long time to do. So, would you rather continue to see cinematic showcases with reviews paired together at a slower pace, or would you rather see reviews at a faster pace, or maybe a mix of both? I really want to know what you think, so please let me know down in the comments below. And right before we dive into my thoughts about this game, this is not a sponsored review. I just want to really talk about this game because it's freaking mind-blowing, and I'm genuinely excited for this game, this campaign. I don't even remember the last time I was this excited and this hyped for a Kickstarter board game campaign. And quick premise, I am giving my thoughts on the prototype version I received, which has 4 heroes and 2 monsters to play with. I cannot wait for more. All right, so in its core, Bloodstone is a PvP and PvE intertwined board game. Put very simply, you pick a champion, you play a set of cards that determine player order, and the card with the highest number is slower but stronger, and the lowest number is weaker but faster. And then you roll dice and then move around the board attacking players. That is an oversimplified breakdown of what you're doing in the game. So again, if you want full details, please go ahead and check out that preview video that I did. Now here's what I was concerned about first playing this game. Two things. One, how would this game play at a lower player count, a 2-player count? I was worried that the gameplay would be stale at smaller player counts, especially since we can't gather together at the moment, and eventually when we can, I still frequently play at 2 players anyway. So that issue was easily resolved within 1 round of gameplay because it is incredibly fun. I love how Bloodstone distills down battle mechanics to a point where I don't feel like it's repetitive, and at the same time there's a solid amount of effects and modes that you have to play with where it's exciting even though you're facing off against just one other player in the arena. You have these challenge cards that give you different incentives to either avoid damage or run towards rewards instead of fighting other players right from the get-go, and those challenge cards can be added 1 at a time or 2 or 3, it's up to you depending on how nuts you want that fight to be. You also have catch mechanics, so even if you know it's not your lucky day, you'll gain these permanent bonuses that help you fight. On top of that, the 4 characters that I've experienced so far, they are actually truly unique. I personally really love Uwazi, who plays like the glass cannon. Uwazi is the mage in the game, and I play pretty much mages across any game, but he stacks up damage like crazy, and you also wither people away with ignite dice, and you kind of throw meters at them with pyroblast. It is so flippin' fun. You also have a warrior class charging at you, giving you different bleed effects and draining your life away. You have an archer class hitting multiple targets, and you also have a rogue class with poisons. And what's really cool about Lien is actually part of her, it's part of her ultimate. Her cards will get upgraded as if it's a skill tree, so she gets a whole new set of cards moving up. So in PvP, there is a ton of variation, and that's only with 4 heroes and a few challenge cards that I've got to play with so far. So first concern, does it still play well at 2 players? I love it. I found it to be really fun, really exciting, but I'm sure at the 3-player and more count, it's going to be way more interesting, especially with like 2v2s. That's something I'm really looking forward to. And my second concern is actually with the co-op mode. So co-ops, if you've been following the channel for quite some time now, you probably know that I'm not the biggest fan of co-ops because co-ops never really feel like you're making your own decision. I know, despite it being cooperative, still, as a team, if no one is making their own decision and putting in their own input, that's not too fun for me. Bloodstone, however, is one co-op that I am 100% looking forward to because you control your own character. You know, you have your own abilities, you have your own movement, and I feel like everyone is already busy trying to figure out their own combos and dice pulls and ways to attack the monster while trying to avoid damage, that I'm hoping it pushes more for individuality in co-op. Everyone has something different to bring to the table, and it really feels like an MMO RPG in tabletop form. And it makes sense why I've enjoyed this game so much, because it's heavily inspired by Warcraft. I love WoW, I actually just got back into it with Shadowlands, and Bloodstone really feels like the game WoW would be in tabletop form. On top of that, I think the kicker, the factor that really reels me in for co-op gameplay, yes, you gain experience like a campaign and rewards and different items like that, but you also gain the boss's power. The power that's actually being reflective of what the boss used. Spoiler alert, maybe, if you don't want to know about what the boss rewards are. But I like this Mega Man type reward for bosses because with Malvara, you get these meat hooks to push people away and deal damage, just like how that boss, you know, has the push and pull mechanic. And then with the Terror of Everwood, it has this prey token. And that prey token, usually for the monster, it attaches to heroes to deal double damage. But once you defeat the terror, now you gain access to that ability and you gain that prey token that you can attach to opponents as well once you win that monster trophy. But other than that, I've tried to nitpick this game, but I don't know. Currently, I think it just has really, really high potential. Like, if the prototype with four heroes and two monsters already is this entertaining, I can't even imagine what the polished components and the full roster of champions and monsters and arena challenges and rewards and all that is going to play out. So I want to finish off this video by talking about three things that I think would be fun to see down the line for Bloodstone. Now, one is the tier system for Lien. I don't know how the other champions play just yet. I saw a paladin and a monk, I think mentioned somewhere, but I think in general, a tiered system for more than one hero would be really cool. For Lien, when she gets her ultimate, she upgrades her cards and gets a whole brand new set of cards once she gains her ultimate. And I really would love to see that projected onto other heroes as well. But again, I don't really know how balanced the other heroes are or how the other heroes play in general. So I'm definitely anticipating to see what all the other heroes are and how they interact for sure. I also would love to see a Warlock class and maybe even a Bard class if those aren't already mentioned somewhere or aren't already in the works. Number two, so far I think there's only one monster trophy. Now depending on how many bosses are offered in the game, I think it'd be a really cool way to maybe reintroduce the PvE campaign side by having a second or third monster trophy. So let's say, hear me out for a second, let's say you get through all the bosses. I think multiple monster trophies, ergo multiple monster difficulty levels as well, would be awesome, maybe as an expansion. I don't know if there's going to be 6 bosses or 8 bosses or 10. It kind of depends on how much game time you get with the bosses that are already offered in the base game. But I just think it would be really cool to have more than one monster trophy. So like once you finish the campaign for the monsters one time, you go through it again, but the monsters now have a higher difficulty level and they also have an alternative trophy, something like that. And thirdly, I'm very interested in solo play. Normally, I also don't play solo games often, but this is also one game I would easily dive into playing solo. So I really want to see how that mode plays out as well. And those are my thoughts on Bloodstone. But more importantly, what do you think about this game so far? Comment down below what your thoughts are. And with that, thank you all so much for watching, for being here, and enjoy the campaign. I'll see you all in the next video.